All right, so strangely enough, the Tesla Model Y does not come standard with a HomeLink garage door opener. So in my case, what I did to overcome that was install a smart garage door opener. I'm using one from a company called Nexx, and what I enjoy about that one is the fact that it doesn't have any additional monthly charges. Some of the major garage door opener companies have their own solutions, like Chamberlain has the MyQ product, but last I checked, that had a monthly fee, and I wasn't really interested in having another subscription service on my monthly credit card statements. So now let me show you how I have Nexx Garage integrated into my home setup here. Hey Siri, open the garage door.
Okay, done. Device activated to open.
And then when you're leaving, all you need to do to close the garage door is activate a Siri shortcut. Hey Siri, close the garage door.
Okay, done. Device activated to close.
You can use this Just Drive feature, which will do location awareness. So it will auto open the garage when you are close to your house, and you can set the trigger radius just in a bubble around your house. So as you pull up to your house, your garage door will automatically start opening, which is really convenient. And I would say it works most of the time. It's not 100% perfect. I think sometimes they have issues with their cloud service, but for free, I'm not going to complain too hard.
Still on it. Uh-oh, something's wrong. Please try again. Sorry, there's something wrong. Please try again.
Hey Siri, close the garage door.
Okay, done. Device activated to close.
All right, so here we are in my garage, and as you can see here, I have a Chamberlain LiftMaster, and up top here, I've got the Nexx Garage. And this is the actual communication module. So let me show you how I have that connected here. So I have the Nexx Garage plugged into this AC outlet here, and the wiring just kind of tucks over here and then comes back into the unit. And then you have these red and black cables that come off of the Nexx Garage. And all you need to do is come down to your wiring terminals. And the Nexx Garage wires are gonna share the same ports as your garage door opener. And during the Nexx Garage setup, there's an option where you use jumpers to double check that you're putting it in the right place. So as you can see, I'm sharing the black wire with the run for the garage door opener. And then down over here is where the contact sensor is for Nexx Garage. So as you can see here, you can attach contact sensors to the top of your garage door so that it can detect when your garage door is actually open and closed. So as you can see, this contact sensor travels all the way down here. And then when it meets its friend that's currently attached to my wall, it lets Nexx Garage know that the garage door is actually closed. So there's also the native Nexx Garage app where you can manually control the garage door open and close if you didn't want to use a Siri or Alexa or Google Assistant type of integration there. So you can just push and long hold on this button and it will open your garage door and give you the real-time status of the garage door operation. So now it's currently open. And if I push again, it should close the garage door for me. And this is also great because if you left the house for the day and you're not sure if you've closed your garage door, then this will let you know so you don't have to turn around and double check. And lastly, when you go under settings, here's some of the additional things you can do. So there's notifications that you can set up. So if you're not home, you can still be notified if someone else opens or closes the garage door, even if it's manually and not using the app. It'll just let you know the status of the garage door, or if you forgot to shut it, it will let you know as well. And I showed you the Just Drive feature at the top of the video where it will open the garage door as you're driving up based on your GPS trigger radius that you set in here. And that works most of the time, but maybe has about a 20% failure rate, honestly, in my experience. And then in that case, I just have to either use the app or just try a manual Siri command to get that going. And lastly, if you go down under the Works With option at the bottom, you can see that this will work with Alexa, Google Assistant, SmartThings, or Siri. So I'll put my parts list in my video description. And if you have any questions, leave those in the comments section. Please click on the like button to let me know how I did on this video. And consider subscribing to my channel for more great tech reviews. Thanks for watching.